Hey, this is DJ from DJ's Trains on YouTube, and this is part 3 about how to build a model train layout, where we're going to cover the wiring, DCC, the fascia, and some ballast. So let's take a look at where we're at so far. This is the first module, and we're going to tackle the wiring first. Now, if you remember in the last video, I placed 3 feeders, 2 on this side, and 1 on the opposite side. Those are the 3 feeders for now. But looking underneath the table, which I told you is from the previous layout, you'll see that I now have white and black what are called bus wires. The bus wires are a thicker wire than the feeder wires. A real simple diagram of how my layout is wired. In this situation, I'm using purple and brown to illustrate my bus wires. And then using those little wire caps, I had attached my feeder wires, and I mark them left and right, and that you make sure that those wires do not cross. You have to stay consistent. And then right in the middle, I just simply spliced in some wires to go to my DCC system. It is that simple. I fished the wires through some holes in the framework, and this keeps the wires from hanging down, and it gets me ready for whenever I'm ready to expand the layout. If you wanted to use a simple DC power pack, you can just simply attach that to your bus wires. For me, I'm using DCC, and I'm using the NC power cab, which is shown here. It's really simple. I really like it. Now, to hide the wiring and to give a neater appearance, we're going to put on some fascia. And fascia is made from hardboard. Hardboard is sold in 4x8 sheets at hardware stores. And I had already cut it down to sections like this, which I can use for the backdrop eventually. And then just a little piece for up front. And I had already cut a little spot for my DCC system. I just had to cut out a little slot just so I can get the circuit board through, but yet not too wide so that the faceplate could be screwed onto the hardboard. I screwed the fascia in with some small screws, and notice it is not the full length. That is because I'm going to eventually attach the next section of the layout there, and I didn't want to have to cut the fascia after it's already been installed. I fished the wires of the DCC system through the fascia. And you can have it either way, where the red indicator light is on the bottom or on the top. The instructions will tell you more about that. And then I just use some nice little screws to attach it to the fascia. The other wires I attached to the bus wires, just simply stripping off some insulation, wrapping the wires around. Eventually I covered it all with black electrical tape. And I'm ready to go. And I forgot to show you, there is a power cord that attaches to the back of this real easy. There's a red indicator light. If it's on the bottom, then you simply plug your power cab into the left-hand side, and your power cab turns on.
That's so awesome, isn't it? Okay, we're going to show you how to program an engine. And in this situation, yeah, the book will show you how to do programming tracks. I'm going to make this easy as possible. Program. Yes, we're going to program on the main. Enter. Okay, it knows that that's engine number 3. It's the only engine on the track. So, yes. Number 1. This will be the address. We're going to do the long address. Number 1. The long address is CSX 600. 1, enter. Okay, let's see how it works. It was that easy. It's that easy. Change direction, go back the other way. Let's do some horn. Long, long. Short, long, bell. Okay, back it up a little bit. Forward direction, turn the headlight on. You can see that the headlights on the engine. I mean, it's that easy. So I'm gonna move it out of the way. Now he's just gonna stay there and idle. This guy's gonna be working the industrial part. Former U.S. Steel engine, number 536. So, he's going to stay consistent, okay? So, I can do this here. Select loco. That's my 536. Enter. Let's see if he moves. DCC is that easy.
We're going to work on some track, and the first thing I want to do is glue it down. But for glue, I am using this Alex Plus clear silicone. Apply bead, and then just get a little piece of plastic or something to kind of smooth it out. You want to make sure you don't have big clumps in it. So you can kind of do what I do, just kind of smooth it out. You can cover the whole roadbed. Now, I am only doing this one track for this video. This is going to be a dummy track. This is going to represent the Norfolk Southern. Do not use this underneath switches or anything that will move like a switch. So I smoothed it out. And I placed my track, and you'll feel it'll grip a little bit. But I still hold it down with those little tiny little brads, those little tiny nails. In this section, yes, I'm still using the cork roadbed because this is going to be the Norfolk Southern main line, so of course it's going to be raised. And maybe in a future video I'll show where I transition from the cork roadbed down to the ground level. So once that dried, it doesn't move, but I take the pins out. And now it's time to ballast. Nothing out of the ordinary. I'm just using Woodland Scenic's ballast. Rubbing alcohol. You can get like the 70 or 85%. Some water, a spoon, a syringe, some little bowls. And then we're going to use some Elmer's glue. So the first thing you want to do is you want to put your ballast down. And I like to put the ballast into a bowl. Now sometimes I mix the colors of the ballast in a bowl like that. It works perfectly. But then just use a spoon, and for the first round you're basically just going to try to get it all in between the ties. In between, not on top, but in between the ties. And so I like to use my finger to smooth it out and kind of make sure that the ballast goes between the ties. Do not do large sections at one time. Maybe just like a couple feet at the most. So once I get all the ballast where I want, I'm going to use a paintbrush and just kind of make sure that it's off the top of the ties. Now, here's something that I kind of figured out on my own. I'm mixing rubbing alcohol with water. And the reason why is whenever I was using just straight rubbing alcohol, especially when I do this for scenery, it just felt like it would get flimsy. Sometimes it would even peel up a little bit. So I'm using pretty much a 50-50 mix of rubbing alcohol and water. Now, why you got to do this? Because if you put just water onto that dry ballast, it will mess everything up. The alcohol is what breaks it up and allows the water to penetrate and yeah, if you don't believe me, try this yourself with just water. It will just roll off of it, but you have to mix it with rubbing alcohol. Now here I use a syringe, and this is the also huge important part is you go directly on top of the rail. Once again, on top of the rail, and then you just let it kind of just roll off the rail into the ballast, and eventually it will cover the entire ballast. Don't go directly on the ballast. Go on top of the rail. These are all things I learned the hard way. So while that's wet, I mix. For this time, I use 50-50 water and Elmer's glue. I think in the future I'm probably going to change that ratio to maybe 60% water to 40% white glue. People use matte medium and things like that. There's some already mixed stuff you can buy in hobby stores. And normally I also pour this into a bottle, but I'm doing this just for the video's sake. So it's a 50-50 mix of water and Elmer's glue. Now stir it with a popsicle stick. In a bottle, you can really shake it up and make sure that it mixes good. So here's where you're thinking, oh, Deej, you went a little bit heavy. Yeah, but it works. You got to trust me on this. I know, when you first start doing this, you're thinking, oh, crap, did I mess this up? No. You, like I said, I'm probably going to use a little bit more water than Elmer's glue in the future. But when you're using the syringe and you do it on top of the rail, and once again, it'll gradually work its way into all of the ballast. I personally don't like the ballast around moving switches. But look, it dried. See? I always say, never panic. Now, I went to work, so I was gone like 13 hours when I came back. This was dry. And if you really want to test it out, once it's dry, you can go over it with a little shop vac or just go over it with your fingers. Look, nothing came loose. That worked perfectly. So yeah, ballasting, it seems intimidating, but you can do it. Well, that's going to wrap up that part of the video. I wanted to show you where I work, and here we have an eastbound on number one main, and look at the ballast difference between that and the yard here at Riverton. So in future videos, I'll show you how I ballast to look more like that. I got trapped in at work. Another train blocked the only road out. So I was stuck. So I played with the drone. So subscribe to my channel, DJ's Trains. Check out my Facebook and Twitter and Instagram. And I'll see you guys in the next video.